Though established as an official federal holiday in 1971, Memorial Day dates to the mid-19th century following the American Civil War in 1865, when veterans from both sides, including freed slaves, held tributes at the graves of their fallen comrades. Following World War I in 1918, veterans and their loved ones wore a red poppy in memory of those who died and recited poetry to honor those who sacrificed their lives for freedom. Today, veterans and active duty members of our embassy will present a Memorial Day poem by C.W. Johnson.
We walked among the crosses where our fallen soldiers lay and listened to the bugle as taps began to play.
The chaplain led a prayer. We stood with heads bowed low and thought of fallen comrades I had known so long ago.
They came from every city across this fertile land that we might live in freedom. They lie here neath the sand.
I felt a little guilty. My sacrifice was small. I only lost a little time, but these men lost their all.
Now the services are over for this Memorial Day. To the names upon these crosses, I just want to say,
thanks for what you've given. No one could ask for more. May you rest with God in heaven from now through evermore.
For more than 150 years, Americans have marked Memorial Day by honoring the sacrifices of our servicewomen and men. Today, we also have the opportunity to remember our partners and friends in arms, those we've trained and fought with, and those who've lost their lives. We honor the 32 Georgian soldiers who gave their lives in service to NATO missions, as well as the 290 soldiers who have been injured. It is through our continued defense and security partnership that these memories remain strong in the hearts of our people, driving us forward toward a deeper, more prosperous and secure future. As President Biden says, may God protect our troops.